For centuries, humans have built dams to control rivers, generate power, and even reshape entire landscapes. But what if we took that idea to the extreme? Not just a dam on a river, not just a dam on a lake, but a dam so massive, so ambitious, that it could seal off an entire sea. It sounds impossible, but the minds behind this idea believe it's not just feasible, but it could change the world forever, providing insane amounts of hydropower for centuries to come. Hey, I'm your host Regis, and today we're diving into the crazy plan to dam the Red Sea. If you think that sounds like a bonkers idea, well, strap in, because it's only going to get wilder from here. In 2007, a group of scientists and a professor published a paper examining the potential effects of cutting off the Red Sea. As a thought experiment, they suggested that we build a gigantic dam wall, 150 meters high and 1 kilometer thick, stretched across the shallowest part of the Bab al-Mandeb Strait. They don't mention the exact location, but drawing a dam at the narrowest point like this one would make it around 28 kilometers long. In their paper, they even talk about it being 100 kilometers long. Those numbers are mental if you consider that one of the world's largest dams, the Three Gorges Dam in China, is only 2.3 kilometers long. Of course, any rational person's first question to this will probably be, why would anyone want to dam the Red Sea? You see, the idea behind this macro engineering project was to close up this body of water and drain it through evaporation so that we could use it to generate hydroelectric power. Let's break this down to show you exactly how all this is supposed to work. By separating the Red Sea from the Indian Ocean, this dam would stop ocean water from flowing into the sea. The water inside the dam would then begin to steadily evaporate, resulting in a water level that's lower than the ocean. Ocean water would then be allowed back into the Red Sea, turning those turbines and ultimately generating hydroelectricity. The authors of this thought experiment call this type of renewable energy heliohydroelectric power generation, as it uses the sun to keep water levels low. This was the core idea behind this proposal to dam the Red Sea, and there's a reason why they chose this part of the ocean. You see, this unique sea is extremely warm, with surface temperatures that can reach up to 30 degrees Celsius. These high temperatures cause the water to evaporate at one of the highest rates in the world. Now, let's take a quick dive into how much power the Red Sea Dam could actually generate. The key to making this work is balance, allowing in just as much water as evaporates over time. That way, the system stays stable while continuously generating energy. Since evaporation depends on the surface area of the water, that's the first big factor to consider. But there's another big player here, potential energy, or how much power we can squeeze out of the water. Put more simply, this depends on the hydraulic head, which is basically the height difference between the water flowing at the top and the turbines. This is where it all comes together. The water level and the surface area of the Red Sea are connected to the length of the hydraulic head. Let's look at two separate extremes. Imagine if the Red Sea was just slightly lower than the Indian Ocean. The reservoir would have a huge surface area, so a large amount of water would evaporate and therefore flow in. But the water wouldn't have much potential energy to generate power. Not great. Now, picture the opposite. The sea level drops by 1,500 meters. The potential energy would be insane, but the remaining reservoir would be tiny, meaning that we couldn't release much water. Also not great. Neither scenario is ideal, and the sweet spot lies somewhere in between. And here's where this chart comes in. It perfectly illustrates the relationship between these variables. As you can see here, according to the study, the optimum hydraulic head would be 611 meters. That means the Red Sea would need to evaporate down by 611 meters to reach peak power generation. And based on their models, getting to that point would take about 291 years. Yeah, almost 300 years. Considering that, this dam would have a generating capacity of around 50 gigawatts of hydroelectric power. Given that 1 gigawatt is enough to power 750,000 homes, a dam like this operating at full capacity could provide clean, renewable energy for more than 37 million homes. That's just insane. So let's assume that this macro engineering project could actually be built. What kind of problems would we encounter? Well, trust me, there's a lot. And before we take a look at these problems and how we could actually build the Red Sea Dam, we quickly want to thank our long-term partner, CyberGhost VPN, for sponsoring this video. With over 38 million users worldwide and over 20,000 excellent reviews on Trustpilot, it's one of the best VPNs out there. So let us quickly tell you why CyberGhost is such a great choice. A VPN is essential for protecting your digital privacy. Plenty of eyes are watching you every time you go online, and even incognito mode doesn't prevent that. Your internet service provider, your school or work's IT department, even your home Wi-Fi router, they can all track what you do online. And that's where CyberGhost VPN comes in. Simply select one of their over 100 locations before you browse to encrypt and reroute all of your traffic through their secure servers. This way, no one will even know about your online activity. CyberGhost also unlocks geo-restricted games and content from over 40 streaming platforms, like Netflix, Amazon Prime, and Disney Plus. And you can even score better deals online by simply changing your virtual location. It works on all major devices and operating systems, Windows, macOS, Android, iOS, and you can protect up to 7 devices at the same time, perfect for sharing with friends and family. With our link, cyberghostvpn.com/megabuilds, you get their best deal ever. Just $2.03 a month plus 4 months for free, which is 84% off. There's even a 45-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. It's a great product, we can definitely recommend it, and by signing up using our link in the description, you also help us to create more videos like this one. And now, back to the Red Sea Dam. For one, there's the obvious question of the dam's environmental impact. You see, damming the Red Sea will greatly increase the salt concentration in the water, and this part of our ocean is already pretty salty. By evaporating the sea, the salinity will keep on increasing and cause massive problems for marine animals and coral reefs. All the salt will lead to these organisms being dehydrated and killed, because they're simply not used to such an environment. This huge evaporation project would also be disastrous for the area's coastal wetlands and mangroves. These biodiverse and vital ecosystems will dry up and die as soon as the dam wall goes up. And if you're thinking that this may cause more land to free up for agricultural activities, think again. The authors of this experiment themselves warned that it'll only result in salt-laden soil that, together with dust, will end up polluting the atmosphere. They compared it to what happened when the Soviets started draining the Aral Sea in the 1960s. Over the course of 3 decades, the Aral Sea went from the 4th largest lake in the world to a mere speck of water. Only 10% of it remains today, and the salts and toxic dust left behind causing health risks for millions of people in the region. On top of that, the water that currently flows into the Red Sea would have to go somewhere if we cut it all off. According to the writers of this novel idea, this will cause sea levels to rise by 12 centimeters over 50 years and reach a maximum of 30 centimeters in around 310 years. And as we all know by now, higher sea levels could lead to millions of displaced people who call coastal areas their home. So there are some concerns voiced by the science writers themselves, but perhaps the biggest question of all is, could this even be built? Well, before we get into that, we'd appreciate it a lot if you'd subscribe to MegaBuilds. Thank you so much for your support. Now, let's get back to the question of how you would actually build this dam. So far, we've seen the challenging numbers involved in building a dam across the Bab al-Mandeb Strait, but a smaller dam would also need to be put in place at the southern end of the Gulf of Suez. This second dam will block water flowing in from the Mediterranean Sea. It would be slightly easier to build this upper part of the Red Sea Dam than the one down south, because it would be much shorter, and its height would need to be less than 100 meters. There's also some seismic activity to be factored in here. The movement of tectonic plates causes the Red Sea to widen by approximately 10 millimeters every year. Add to that an increase in evaporation that will leave behind a heavier salt layer, and it's likely that even more tectonic movements could occur under this shifting weight. The scientists behind this wild idea suggest that elastic materials be used to compensate for the movements and expansion of the Red Sea. What exactly those are, well, that's anyone's guess. Of course, to build such a humongous dam would require a lot of concrete. While these thinkers don't comment on just how much will be needed for a dam this size, if we compare it to the size of the Three Gorges Dam, it would need at least 12 times as much concrete and steel to complete. Not only will this be an incredibly ambitious construction project, but it would also disrupt shipping routes. Draining the Red Sea would essentially prevent European and Asian countries from using it as a shortcut for shipments. This would be a hard ask, because today around 95% of maritime trading between Europe and Asia happens along the Red Sea route. The alternative would mean that ships would have to go all the way around the African continent, which is clearly a much longer route and would naturally be more expensive. And speaking of cost, we simply have to ask the question, what will the price tag be for the Red Sea Dam? According to the paper's lead author, Roelof Dirk Skoiling, the main dam will cost as much as $220 billion to complete. And that was in 2007. To compare, the Three Gorges Dam ended up costing around $30 billion. So, yeah, with a price like that, the massive disruption in maritime trade, and the devastating environmental impact of such a project, it's no wonder that this thought experiment hasn't turned into reality. But what do you think about ideas like this? Have you ever heard of this concept of helio-hydroelectric power before? Drop us your thoughts and comments down below. And if you want to try CyberGhost VPN, make sure that you use our link in the description. CyberGhost VPN will protect your data while you browse and give you full access to all blocked content on the internet. It's a great VPN, just like their current deal for $2.03 a month and 45 days money back guaranteed. So it's totally risk-free. As always, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.